Good morning. We just learned about three different types of energy. Class, could you please name all three?
Flippin' physics.
Kinetic energy.
Gravitational potential energy.
The spring one. Elastic potential energy. Those are all examples of mechanical energy. Mr. Terry of Houston, Texas has agreed to do our example for today. Good morning, Mr. Terry.
Good morning, Mr. P.
Please, go ahead.
Sure. Right here I have a 3.6 kilogram mass, which I'm about to drop from a height of 2.0 meters. So I'll go ahead and do that right now. So, and in 3, 2, 1, drop. And there you have it.
Thank you, Mr. Terry.
You're welcome, Mr. P.
Okay. Again, we have a mass of 3.6 kilograms, which we are dropping from a height of 2.0 meters. Initially, Bo, at the very top, what is the kinetic energy of the mass?
Well, kinetic energy, or the energy of motion, is equal to 1/2 times the mass of the object times the square of the object's velocity. So, because the mass has an initial velocity of zero, the initial kinetic energy of the mass is zero.
And Bobby, tell me how much gravitational potential energy the mass has initially.
Gravitational potential energy equals mass times the acceleration due to gravity times the vertical height above the horizontal zero line. So 3.6 times 9.81, positive 9.81. Oh, wait a minute. We need to set our zero line. So let's put our horizontal zero line at the ground where the mass lands.
Technically, at the center of the mass of the object, right before it lands.
Right, the zero line is at the center of mass of the object. Therefore, the initial vertical height of the object is 2 meters. So the gravitational potential energy initial is 70.632, or with two significant digits, 71 joules.
Let's round our data right now to the tenths place, so 70.6 joules. And I think you would all agree that we can analyze the velocity of the object using what we know about the concept of free fall. And I've done all those calculations and placed them in the lecture notes, which you can see at flippingphysics.com if you'd like to. And once we have the velocity of the object, we can determine the kinetic energy and the gravitational potential energy of the mass as a function of time. Right, class?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
And this is a table that shows the vertical height of the object above the horizontal zero line, the time from when the object was dropped, the velocity of the object, the gravitational potential energies, and the kinetic energies, all in increments of 1/3 of a meter from the top. You can see, as the height of the object decreases, the magnitude of the velocity increases, which we should already know from our study of free fall. And therefore, the kinetic energy will also increase as the height of the object decreases. In addition, as the height of the object decreases, the gravitational potential energy of the object also decreases. Now, those are the numbers. However, it is also useful to look at these numbers in graph form. This is a graph of the gravitational potential energy of the object as a function of time. Clearly, the gravitational potential energy of the object decreases as the height of the object decreases. We can add the kinetic energy to the graph as well, and you can see the kinetic energy increases as the height of the object decreases. But notice what happens when we include the total mechanical energy on the graph. When we add together at every point along the curve, the gravitational potential energies and kinetic energies, they always add up to the same value. 70.6 joules, or the total mechanical energy with which the object started. This is called conservation of mechanical energy. The idea that energy is neither created nor destroyed. Energy simply changes form. The gravitational potential energy is converted to kinetic energy as the object falls.
That's pretty cool, Mr. P. The total mechanical energy stays the same the whole time the object is falling.
Actually, can you put the data table back up and add a column for the total mechanical energy?
Sure, I can do that.
Yep. The total mechanical energy at every point adds up to 70.6 joules. Very nice, Mr. P.
Thanks. That's conservation of mechanical energy. in the equation for conservation of mechanical energy is the total mechanical energy initial equals the total mechanical energy final.
Mr. P?
Yes, Bo?
When is mechanical energy conserved?
Good question.
That's a good question.
Mechanical energy is conserved as long as no energy is converted to heat, light, or sound energy via work done by friction, and no energy is added to or removed from the system via work done by a force applied. Thank you very much for learning with me today.
Mr. P?
Yes, Billy?
Could you please explain when mechanical energy is conserved again? I didn't really understand that.
Sure. First, the work done by the force of friction needs to be equal to zero. So you could either have no friction, or the two surfaces need to not slide relative to one another. An example when mechanical energy is not conserved would be as I push on this water bottle. As I push on the water bottle, there is work done by the force of friction on the water bottle, and the kinetic energy of the water bottle is then being converted to heat and sound energy, sometimes light energy, but not this time. Therefore, when that happens, the work done by the force of friction is not equal to zero, therefore mechanical energy is not conserved. Also, in order to have mechanical energy be conserved, the work done by the force applied needs to be equal to zero. So, as I lift this ball upward, I am doing work on this ball via a force applied. And in other words, I am adding energy in the form of gravitational potential energy right now via the work done by the force applied. So as I lift the ball up, mechanical energy is not conserved because the work done by the force applied adds energy, gravitational potential energy, to the system. When I drop this ball, as the ball falls, the work done by the force applied is equal to zero because there is no force applied. There's also no force of friction. Therefore, the work done by the force of friction is equal to zero. Therefore, as the ball falls, mechanical energy is conserved.
So mechanical energy will be conserved for an object in projectile motion, right?
Correct, Billy. Another example would be this pendulum. There is no force applied and no force of friction, therefore no work done by either two of those forces, therefore mechanical energy is conserved. If we set the horizontal zero line at the lowest point for the pendulum, it has zero gravitational potential energy there and the maximum kinetic energy. As it swings up to the top, its kinetic energy decreases while its gravitational potential energy increases. And at the top, it has no kinetic energy and a maximum amount of gravitational potential energy. I call it the dance of the pendulum. Gravitational potential energy, kinetic energy. 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 Two partners dancing back and forth. The dance of the pendulum. Conservation of mechanical energy. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
I want my $2.